in this video, I'm going to show you a play that you can use against the man coverage meta, especially the press coverage meta, that will really help you move the ball down the field and actually maybe get some big plays. What's up, guys? My name is Cody, and I want to thank you for taking the time to watch this YouTube video. Now, if you're brand new to the channel and you don't know what my channel is about becoming a better Madden player. So if you're looking to get better at Madden, go ahead and click the subscribe button at the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. Research has shown me that only actually 38% of you guys have actually subscribed to the channel. So if this is your first time coming by the channel, or if you come by a lot, make sure to go ahead and subscribe. That way you can get access to all of our Madden 21 videos and tips and strategies. We do new videos every single day here on the channel, and it's completely free to subscribe. So if you don't enjoy the content, you can always unsubscribe at a later time. Okay, guys, so I wanted to talk specifically about this cover two man defensive meta shift that you're seeing a lot of people use. And this play comes to us from the Seattle Seahawks offensive playbook. Now, if you got my offensive ebook, which was on the bunch tight end specifically formation, this playbook has most everything that you need to run an effective bunch tight end. It also has one of the best gun bunches in the game, and it has this trips tight end offset formation, which is a very, very effective formation to dive into. So the point is, this can have some of those things. So if you haven't picked up the Gun Bunch tight end ebook, in my opinion, it's the most effective offense in the game. And when you go against defenses that are like heavy press man coverage, you could potentially audible to this play out of the Gun Bunch that I'm about to show you. But if you want to get that full offense, that is in the description of this video. The play we're going to be going over today is the clear out SE out play. And basically what people like to do is they like to shade coverage down, or shade coverage underneath, essentially. And all you're going to basically do with this is you're just going to basically smart route your tight end. You're going to streak Chris Godwin. And then with the running back, what I like to do is put him on a Texas pattern. And then all we're going to do is we're going to motion Antonio Brown to the right. And we're going to snap him at the numbers, right? So about the 20-yard line right there. And what you'll see here is you can basically pass this outside, and you have a pretty good chance at getting this open. Now, again, a lot of people, like I said, they're going to shade their coverage. They're going to do all this stuff. So if you can time this motion snap of Brown, you'll see here he's going to get that outside release, so you can get it way out there before the safety gets there. And as long as you have somebody that's going over the top, like Chris Godwin here, then this should do a pretty good job. Now, if that doesn't work for you, you can also hit this tight end route. This tight end post route is really effective against man coverage. It's actually really, really effective against it in mutt, because you can get tight ends there that have they'll have like 90 route running over the middle, which will really, really help this. Another little trick that you can do with these routes to Antonio Brown is you can actually smart route his route. So you can see how I can get that swerve catch over the top of the defense just like that right there. So that's something that you need to monitor. Now, what a lot of people will do out of this shaded coverage, especially against Gun Bunch, is they will do something like this. They will basically roll the coverage into essentially a cover one press. And the reason why is to stop this route to the tight end. Well, that's why you have this setup right here, because if they do something like that, then now you're really going to be able to just roast them. As you see right there, and again, Brady doesn't have gunslingers, so that's the one issue with this. But because I didn't get that pass lead to the outside, the safety was able to come over and play it. But what you'll notice is basically what's going to happen is Antonio Brown should get wide open here for us. He's going to get kind of a free release on that motion. And then basically you're just passing this to the right, and just make sure that you swerve catch it. So you have that route in your arsenal. Now, in mutt, where you have a little bit faster receivers, that can be very, very beneficial. Even in regs, a lot of people are going to shift to playing a lot of regs now, because the next tournament for the Madden community is going to be on head-to-head regs. So with that kind of foreknowledge, you know, it's just something to kind of be thinking about. But as you see right there, we get over the top, and we're able to basically click on and swerve catch and get over the top of that player. So you have those two routes. Now, the other thing that you have going for you is we all know that press coverage, right, if they play cover one out of it, what you'll notice here is Mike Evans should get basically over an outside shoulder release. And if you lob it up, you can click on and kind of get over the top of that. Now, right there, Perry Nickerson has a little bit of a speed advantage. But if they were a little bit more similar in speed, that would really easily work. Now, if you don't want to use that fade on the outside for this specific play, that's fine. All you need to do is you could just put him on a standard fade. So you see here, and he's on that outside releasing fade route. The reason that that matters is because now what you're going to see is he's going to get a mandatory outside release and almost always will get a free release off the jam, as you see right there, that hot routed fade over the top. And this was a play that, and of course, Brady's arm is killing me right now. This is a fade that J-Wall used in his tournament game. It's actually a route that he used against Pavin in the Madden Club Championships Finals. He used it from trips tight end, but all he did was basically took this guy on the outside and just put him on a fade route. And I know it seems simple, but you'll see that instant win animation that he gets over the safety, click on, and as you can see right there, he has a step on him. Now, Brady, for whatever reason, has had a really hard time making these throws today. But anyway, you kind of see the idea of what we're trying to accomplish. Now, that's all the while you have these two crossers in the middle of the field. So this is a really powerful play, in my opinion, for not only man coverage, but you see here the running back, that angle route, I think that route's going to become more popular. It was very popular in the beginning of the year, and then people kind of stopped using it, to be honest with you. They used motion slants more. They just didn't use the running back on an angle route. Now I think you're going to see people, kind of shift back into using that angle route because it's so good against the one-step ahead meta that a lot of people are running. You see right there, it just gets a really tender spot, and you're able to hit that route really, at will. And a lot of people have Hot Route Master at this point in the year for Mutt. Now for Regs, in my opinion, the two best teams that you want to be using are the Bucks. You either want to use the Bucks or you want to use the Packers, in my opinion. The Bucks are really, really good, though. But anyway, so this play does beat man-to-man relatively well. Like I said, the first two things that you want to do, because really what you're going to do if you hit these streaks on the outside are primarily for when their safeties are not, when their safeties are taken away. You'll see here on the right side, if I hard right pass lead it, I have a chance to hit that if that is a gunslinger quarterback. But because it's not a gunslinger quarterback, that's where I'm running into issues, and that pass lead is not, really, really, viable. One of the other things that you can do, though, is, like I said, you can get him out there just a little bit more, get that free release, and then basically it's just hard right-click on. You see right there, we're almost able to get that over the top of that safety, but it's kind of a tight throw. But that being said, the rest of the play, you're going to notice here that, we're going to be able to pretty much just take man coverage by storm. We have the two crossing routes, the one to the tight end, and then the angle route to the running back. And then the streaks are basically just clearing out the space under the middle, and they can't use her both of them. They can use her one or the other. So whoever they choose not to use her, that's who you're going to go to. But both routes will beat man-to-man over the middle. You'll see here there the tight end route does a good job of beating man-to-man. And then, like I said, once they start taking their safeties away to stop like that post route, because that's what they'll have to do, then you can come back and hit this route to Antonio Brown. Another thing that you can do if you wanted to, I really like motioning Brown out, but another little setup that you can do off of this is you could do something like this right here, where you basically take Chris Godwin and put him on a whip route, and then you do this combination here. And what you'll see is if he doesn't get pressed, he'll get wide open against, pretty much any defense. So you have that as well as another option. And it also does a good job of clearing space for your running back to be able to come underneath it. So you see you can create this kind of combo right here. And as you can see here, there's so much room for the running back to be able to get open. So all that to say, that is one of the ways that I like to beat man coverage out of the gun bunch formation in the Seattle Seahawks offensive playbook. I think Seattle's got one of the best gun bunches in the Madden in the game right now. So I'm going to be doing some videos on that today. A lot of you have been asking for more gun bunch videos, so we're going to do a couple more today. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure if you have not already got the Bunch Tight End ebook that you do. I think it is the most effective offense in Madden right now. It's got some of the best routes, and it's a very simple scheme to run, very, very effective. Now, if you have any questions or you want to get my full gun bunch offense, go ahead and text me. My number is 812 812- 216-3644. And just a quick reminder, if you want to get that Bunch tight end ebook that I just released, it's very, very simple. A lot of people have had great results with it. Some guys, one of the guys went, several actually guys have gone top 100 in weekend league using this offense. So that link is in the description. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll see you guys on tonight's live stream at 10 o'clock p.m. Eastern time.